Hello.
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 Come on, give it a go. Go power. Come on, give it a go.
Come on, give it a go.
Go power.
Brilliant.
Hello.
Hello.
Come on, give it a go.
Great.
Go power.
Hello.
Hello.
Come on, give it a go.
Hello.
Hello. Come on, give it a go. Go power. Brilliant. Come on, give it a go.
Come on, give it a go.
Go power.
Go power.
Great.
Hello.
Nice to see you. Why don't you come along with me?
Yo, my friend, if you is chilling and willing, I'll take you through a few moves to get you to your own grooves. Know what I mean? You know the sound, so pick me a track and we'll get it on the rack. Use the directional buttons to move from track to track, and when you hear the one you want, hit that X button.
If you wanna be my lover,
all right, my good friend, time for you to shuffle the grooves.
If you wanna be my lover,
zig-a-zig. Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. I wanna Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. 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 Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig.
That you done? Cool, baby. Now you head on out and get your dance moves together.
Wicked mix. Now let's see you dance to it.
Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. 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 I wanna Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. 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 I wanna Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. 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 Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig.
Billy, Billy, Billy wanna zig-a-zig. What are the craziest things that Spice Girls have been asked to do on television?
We did the show in Korea.
And we all had to do something, do like your own little performance.
It made you like do something, a song from a show, or perform a feat, or like really weird, wasn't it?
So I got on the drums, Emma did Grease, and Jerry.
She was the wind.
Told them about an hour before, about when I was about eight, I was in this show and I was the wind. And then suddenly, live telly, they goes, now Jerry's going to be the wind.
You had to be there. It was the most surreal situation. And everybody's like that, clapping. And we're going, I can't believe we're doing this.
But you did have to be there. But I actually think I might have wed myself because it was that funny.
There's another one, right? This is mad.
Taiwan.
You know, they have like these games, audience participation, a bit like torture games. We was asked to do one and us lot refused, but obviously somebody had to do it, so Jerry and Melanie did it.
And they tied Melanie C up and me to each row. It's one, like one of those danger games, do you remember?
Yeah, you know, like the elastic, you know, like bungee
and
jumping.
And they got put on either side of the room on these wangada strings and had to run at each other.
And I was running forward and I thought I was dead clever, like leaning forward. And I totally lost it and I just went smack on the floor like that.
That's how stupid it is.
And then they got off stage and went, aah! It really hurt.
They were all clapping with these plastic things. Yeah, ridiculous.
It's mad over there.
In Japan, is a huge TV show that has, you know, unbelievable amounts of people watching it. So, you know, everything we do, there's reasons behind us doing it.
We do ones where they have puppets, though, and we like to beat them up and take their heads off, but the children get a bit upset, I think.
I didn't mean to.
Didn't you? Are you the tough one?
No.
Good, let's stuff her up.
Come on now. Don't try this at home, children, unless you've got a Spice Girl.
Oi, Nate.
Yes?
I'm the tough one.
Ha!
No! No!
I'll shove off and get to right with you.
What are the worst questions the Spice Girls have ever been asked?
If you was a dog, what kind of dog would you be?
Oh, if you was a biscuit, what kind of biscuit would you be?
If you was a vegetable, what kind of vegetable? I mean, who really cares what sort of vegetable you'd be?
I do!
I mean, you could tell me. You could tell me you could be any sort of vegetable, Melanie, and I'd just be like,
oh, right.
Oh,
right, anyway.
But I suppose some people find it interesting.
Who finds it interesting?
Oh, no, I'll tell you another one. If you had to go and sit on a desert island, what three items would you take with you? We do some weird ones where, you know, we need translators and you've got one translator in this ear, another translator in this ear, and you're listening to someone foreign in front of you. That's always quite tricky.
One chat show we did, it got really, really boring, so we just had a big food fight with this guy's cake on like live TV and nobody could do that about it.
We'd never walk off
a
show because that's just...
We can always handle it.
You can't do that.
If it doesn't make them laugh, we'll certainly have a good laugh between ourselves.
What? You need controlling then, speaking on behalf of American men, do you?
What's more power
because
than that?
Because we'll happily come down there to Seattle and educate you, right?
On girl power.
Yeah, we'll tell you about not being a 90s man, you know, because we girls have got balls.
Who are the Spice Girls' favourite video directors?
We always use a lot of different video directors because, you know, that's part of the process of change. You know, it's very good to get a new look. And also, we only work with people that really, you know, work with our ideas. It's always a two-way thing with us. But I think my favourite director was the Say You Be There video director.
I always felt comfortable with him. I mean, you look at Wannabe video, I mean, that was just such a kind of, here we go, where do I go? I don't know, go here. Do you know what I mean? Our videos are kind of always come from you, yourself.
If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Make it last forever, friendship never ends.
My favourite director was Monty. From Big
TV.
Big TV. He did Two Become One.
And Mama.
And Mama. And just with 2 Become 1, he worked very hard on that. And obviously at the beginning it was just us and our faces, and then he put the whole work behind us.
We always do what we want to do. You know, from day one we were told you should dress the same, you should act the same, you should dance the same, and we've always gone against the grain all the time and done our own thing.
Spice Up Your Life is very Blade Runner-ish. It's very kind of futuristic, and that you could say that's been taken from this and taken from that, but it has, but we've done it in our own little way.
It is hard on a director because they have to take on you as an artist and embrace you, that you're, you know, to embrace everything that you want to project across.
Which venue in the world would the Spice Girls most like to appear in?
Wembley.
We are actually doing, I think we're doing 7 nights at Wembley Arena, but I'd like to do Wembley Stadium.
Obviously, you know, all of us can't wait to walk out and say hello, hello Wembley.
Just to say we've done Wembley Stadium, it's just rock legend.
Yeah, but I always wanted to perform at the Albert Hall, and we did that in the films.
I'd like to do Leeds Theatre or Bradford Alhambra.
I don't share that passion, but I can understand where she's coming from.
Oh, do you know what I'd like to do? Anfield. Now that'd be the pants.
What have been the Spice Girls' most nervous or embarrassing moments?
The two most nerve-wracking things for me is when we've been up to receive awards. That's very nerve-wracking. And the most nervous I've ever been was when we met Prince Charles. I don't know why, I was just really nervous.
You know, I think you're
crazy.
Oh no!
You are. I mean, meeting Prince Charles and having the opportunity to squeeze
and
his
then being
bum.
In cans,
exactly. That is the things that you remember. You know, everything else.
I wish
a
I'd squeezed his bum.
What an opportunity!
When we first went to America, we was all running around in our dressing gowns, you know, like having a laugh and everything. And Jerry was there with a video camera. And I'm running around this really, really posh hotel, and I think I might have had a drink, actually. And we were just running around this hotel, and Jerry was filming me. And I was running around, you know, doing all this. And then there was a lift full of people, and it was really low. It was like 4 o'clock in the morning, and I went like that to a lift full of people, thinking that there wasn't going to be anybody in there. And there was.
What does Nelson Mandela think of the Spice Girls?
Well,
watch it, you stood next to me.
Please, you know, these are my heroines.
And he's our hero as well.
And, I don't want to be emotional, but it's one of the greatest moments in my life.
Hey.
Nelson Mandela said that, you know, other people's exuberance should be liberating. It should. It's catching. It's contagious. So when you're feeling positive about something, that fuels the next person. That fuels the next person. Then it comes back round to you and fuels you even more.
Nelson Mandela's got girl power, boy power. You know, everybody's got it. Single mother parents have got it.
Well, you must realise, of course, that they are talking about an old man.
No. Hey, it's how you young, feel inside. You know,
everybody who's young is always generous to an old man.
No. You're not old. You know, you're as young as the girl you feel, and I'm 25.
How did the Spice Girls enjoy working on their movie?
Metro! Spice Girls! Get ready for the Spice Girls Regimental Shop!
Yes, indeed. Just the power is all we need. We know how we got this far. Strength and courage in a wonderful.
A lot lot to do with the script writing, had a lot to do with the directing. We wrote the second album, which is actually the soundtrack to the film. We had a lot of control within the making of the film.
They don't just sing.
They've got fire in their eyes, hunger in their bellies, and great big shoes on their feet.
Well, none of us had ever done it before, but the only acting I'd ever done is in school plays, do you know what I mean? And then I was working with these top-class actors, actors.
Isn't there much on the telly then?
You know what they're wondering now, don't you?
Yeah.
Can't say you're wondering.
Yeah.
Was it daunting working with professional actors during our movie? I'd say no, because, I mean, we were playing ourselves for a start. It wasn't as if we had to take on a character and do research on that and kind of bring out a different character.
Yeah, if they're being real, then it helps you be real, doesn't it? You can feel when you're being real or not, if you're not being really hammy.
Yeah.
Hello.
I refuse to take any tips, though, because I am the actress of the year, man. I wish. I think, yes, we are easy to work with, as in we're very, very professional. No, we're not probably easy to work with because we know what we like. And we will try out different things, but at the end of the day, oh, we always do what we want to do. So that can be a pain in the for somebody.
Spice World, the movie.
See ya, hold tight.
Do the Spice Girls look forward to working live?
I've been waiting to do a tour since I was about 8 years old, since I first took my first ever dance class. So for me personally, this is something that I've been waiting to do for years, and to get the chance to do it in front of our fans is just like a dream come true. And I'm going to give them the best show you've ever had, right?
Now we got the flavour, the bad behaviour, the rhythm, the melody that took the interview to say if you were rocking about, but somebody's jiving, you need to take a tip, saw it out, get a grip. Never is a rookie on it, but I keep looking at me. But then even if I just go with a loser on the dance floor, take a deep breath, count one, two.
We're going to have about 5 costume changes. Now, obviously, we don't want to make it look too much like a fashion show. You know, at the end of the day, we're not about that. We're about up there and doing it. But obviously, you know, we're girls and we want to change costumes and we want to have some nice spangly costumes.
And there is one where we're actually wearing all the same colour, which is very rare, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. And one when we're all in what appears to be our birthday suit.
Oh, yeah.
So I think the most nerve-wracking thing was thinking, oh my God, can we do it?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? But we can, so it's cool. We're just looking forward to it now.
I'm really looking forward to it. Also, for us, it's something that we can give back to the fans and say, hey, come and, you know, we're going to do this show for you, and it's, you know, it's perfect. We've been rehearsing for quite a few weeks now, so.
I think one thing that we always bear in mind from the beginning, I think we wanted our show to be entertainment.
How do you dance in those shoes?
I don't wear them.
Them big shoes that you wear are quite easy to balance. It's just when you start to go over, that's the bummer.
You see, with those big shoes, you're like that. You're not tipped up. It's higher to dance in a pair of stilettos.
Yeah, Victorias are the hardest shoes to dance
in. You know,
I'm not too great at doing backflips and sort of like leaping around on the floor, do you know what I mean? Whereas, you know, Melanie are.
We like walking on a flat surface. And once you get used to that height, you don't...
Yeah, and you can jump.
I'm sitting dead in myself.
Our dance routines, we make half of it up in the studio when we're actually there.
We make the choreography when we're actually writing the song, like we've just done Stop. Yeah. And we just, you know,
you put it together.
We did that with Save You There, we did that with Love Thing.
Yeah. Who do you think you are is the original of what we did
when we were demoing it in the studio.
And then the other half gets cleaned up by Priscilla, and she'll add like a few things.
If something's freestyle, for example, you know, she'll kind of, I mean, for me personally, she'll put a pair of high heels on and say, you know, how about this, this, this and this. And she gives you the confidence to do that.
But it's always at the end of the day, we do it in our own styles, because I would not dance how Melanie dances or Jerry. You know, we just do it in our own
style. What's wrong with the way I dance?
No, I love it, girl, I love it. It's just, you know.
If the Spice Girls could appear in the movie of their choice, what would it be?
If I could act in one film, or play somebody. I watched The Colour Purple the other day, and I'd probably play somebody in that, because it's a real kind of, that is like a girl power film, that is. It doesn't seem as though it is when it starts off, but the end result of it is, you know what I mean, she gets up and she does her own thing, she goes against the grain as a woman and as a black woman and just goes for it. I'd like to play something like that, something with a bit of reality, something with a bit of intense drama, something that's real.
I'd be Goldie Hawn. Only because she's married to Kurt Russell.
I'd be Demi Moore because she's married to Bruce Willis.
And I think I'd like, the kind of actress I'd like to be is like a bit comedy, but I'd like Jodie Foster. I think she's really cool.
I'd quite like to be, you know, a Bond girl or something like that. And I don't know if they'd want me to be one. You know, or sort of like a Batgirl or something like that. I'm into tight cat suits, so.
you everything.
Be there.
I decided we should be friends.
Thank you.